Women and Child Development and Minister of Textiles, Government of India, to give her address.
Distinguished dais, excellencies in the audience, ladies and gentlemen. The event today is a reminder of the sheer speed of governance under the leadership of Sri Narendra Modi. In the month of November 2019, I approached my colleague Harsimrat Kaur Badal with the intention of coming together and converging our strengths so that we can help women entrepreneurs, women farmers, self-help groups and cooperatives come together under the banner of the Ministry of Food Processing and take their strengths, leverage it with public support and give new opportunities to these entrepreneurs and an added base of getting quality products to our consumers. I am extremely proud to say that under the able leadership of the Minister of Food Processing, today we celebrate the entrepreneurial potential of over 180 women in the segment of organic food under the aegis of this festival. My delightful thanks to the Secretary of Women and Child Development and Secretary of Food Processing, who have come together and converged their efforts administratively to make this event a reality. Speakers before me have highlighted the achievements of our government and the endeavors of Sri Narendra Modi to ensure that we provide a sustainable environment not only to our farmers but also to our entrepreneurs, thereby engaging them with technologies in the area of food processing. It is under his leadership and under the able support of Harsimrat Kaur Badal that we have seen enhanced FDI come into our country specifically for the food processing industry, for which I would like to congratulate her ministry and all her colleagues. Ladies and gentlemen, the government has in the past 5 years ensured that women who never saw a bank engage with them for their entrepreneurial needs get mudra loans. 15 crore such women today in our country, after being supported by the Indian banking system under the aegis of the government, today tell a new story in the Indian entrepreneurship arena. Similarly, the government's commitment to ensure that nutritious food is made available to families and especially women and children can be seen under the Prime Minister's flagship scheme, Poshan. I'm hopeful that today's festival is just the beginning of a long partnership. My gratitude to NIFTM that has endeavored to ensure that the latest technologies available in the sector will be provided to self-help groups, cooperatives and individual female entrepreneurs so that they can enhance their productivity and thereby enrich their business capacities. The government, as you all know, has recently constituted a technology group which will be led by the principal scientific advisor of the Prime Minister, which endeavors to ensure that technologies which are current, competitive and viable from the Indian context are made available for every ministry and every organization so that their endeavor can then be forwarded to individuals across the nation. I am hoping that the Ministry of Food Processing, through the Organic Food Festival, can also endeavor to engage with the technology group so that the latest technology available in the food processing business worldwide can be made available, specially and specifically, to female entrepreneurs in this particular segment. I have requested Ms. Badal that the next year sees an enhanced participation, not only for women, but also those citizens that our Prime Minister calls Divyang. Tribal produce, which is organic in nature, also finds a mention in the festival. Additionally, I think I'll be extremely grateful if we can have a special mention of Paushtik food supported by the Poshan Abhiyan under the aegis of the Organic Food Festival. Yet again, my grateful thanks to the excellencies in the audience. Your presence here today is your commitment to supporting the endeavors of the Ministry of Food Processing and being a partner in India's growth story. Once again, Harsimrat, congratulations and thank you.
Thank you, madam. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my privilege to...